So if you were having a stroke or someone standing next to you were having a stroke, would you be able to tell? Recognizing the signs could really make a difference for you or your loved ones in getting help. Here to talk about that, Josh McDaniel. He is a stroke response nurse at Cone Health. Good morning to you.
Good morning.
So let's talk about those signs. First off, how do you know? I mean, a lot of people say, I feel weird or something like that, but what are some definite signs that you might be having a stroke?
That's right, Brad. So we like to use the word FAST.
Okay.
FAST helps
F-A-S-T. You. F-A-S-T.
Yes, okay. Sir. FAST. It's an acronym that we use to help you determine if someone's having a stroke.
Okay.
The F stands for face. If you look at someone's face, see if there's any kind of facial drooping.
Mm-hmm. That's one thing that people might recognize, that feeling that one may be asymmetrical, one's hanging differently or something.
Correct.
Right?
Okay. Yeah. Ask the person to smile, and if you can see one side's kind of drooping down more than the other side, that could be a sign. Or facial numbness also can be a sign.
Okay, that's the F part.
Correct. The A stands for arms. The arm can be weak or numb as well.
Really?
So what we like to ask people to do is if you raise both arms up and one of them kind of drifts down, that right there is a good sign that they might be having a stroke.
Again, one more than the other.
Right.
Okay, what about the S?
The S stands for speech. Listen to the person speak. Is their speech slurred? Are they having difficulty speaking?
Okay.
You can ask them to repeat a simple phrase like, can't teach an old dog new tricks.
And see if they can mimic that back to you.
Right. Can they repeat the words correctly? And if not, then that could be a symptom as well.
Okay, and then the T, the last component there.
Right, that stands for time. So time is of the essence when someone is possibly having a stroke. You want to act as fast as possible. Call 911, let them know that, hey, I think this person might be having a stroke.
I think the temptation is, hey, well, let me get them in a car and drive them to the hospital, but you say that's not a good idea.
Right. Calling 911 actually pre-notifies the hospital that this person is coming into the hospital with a possible stroke.
Mm-hmm.
That allows us at the hospital to get everything ready for that patient. So as soon as they come in, we're all right there waiting for them and ready to kind of whisk them away into our treatment.
Real quickly, the FAST, face, look for facial drooping. Mm-hmm. The A stands for
arms,
so check the arms and things like that. S is speech, right?
Yes.
Ask them to say, and then time is of the evidence. FAST.
Correct. Yep. And time can also stand for time of onset.
Mm-hmm.
That's a good thing to remember is kind of take note of what time those symptoms started.
Okay.
We'll want to know that when they get into the hospital.
Great information, whether it's you or someone you love. Thanks so much for talking about it today.
You're welcome.
Want to let you know May is Stroke Awareness Month. Cone Health sponsors a number of support groups for people who've suffered a stroke or family members. Check out a cardiac family support group on Tuesday, August 21st. The meeting is from 6 to 8 at Moses Cone Hospital. Need more information? Give them a call at the number on your screen there. There's also a support group for stroke and brain injury patients and their families in Reidsville. That's Monday, June 18th, 1:30 to 2:30 at the Leaf Center. To learn more, give them a call at 336-951-4557.